2014 assembly elections in Maharashtra inches closer. It is not just the political parties who have gone on an overdrive figuring out their campaign strategy, but voters across the city have also expressed their desire to be involved in the campaign and are doing their bit. But with more and more citizen forums now coming up, students have also expressed a keen desire in the upcoming elections. Join me as we find out just how Maharashtra is prepping up for the upcoming assembly elections. The fight for the seat of power in Maharashtra has begun. While some parties are working out last-minute alliances, others are working on strengthening their already existing ones. With 288 assembly seats at stake, everyone's putting their best foot forward. But that is just one side of the story. Voters too are going that extra mile to keep themselves informed about candidates and parties. To find out just how enthusiastic youngsters are about the upcoming assembly elections, we asked them their opinion on a few subjects that really matter. We have with us students from the SIES College of Management Studies. So my first question to all of you is, will you all be voting in the upcoming assembly elections?
Allowed, yes.
So when you're looking to vote, what is it that you're going for, the candidate or the party?
I would say that I would be giving due weightage to both the party, which would define the candidate's political leanings, his political ideology, as well as to the candidate himself. You know, I would see his past track record, whether he has done any service for the community, whether he has been involved in such type of things before. And then I would decide to cast my precious vote for him or her.
And what about you? What is your take on this?
I would say both are equally important. As in, let me put it this way, we can't choose each and every candidate from a different party, and so we can't form a community or a group which will represent us. But so the party matters. But we have to consider the person's background, as in the educational background, what service he has done for the community, how much understanding he has for the society. So yes, for me, both are equally important.
So what are the qualities that you're looking for from the candidate representing you?
As she rightly said, education is one such thing that is important. But basically, we have to look into the purpose, whether the purpose that he has actually come forward for is matching to what he has already preached. And the other thing is that the background of that individual is one such thing that is fundamentally important. We have to see to it that the past records, whether he's actually done something for that particular area, when it comes to the criminal records, that is something that we really need to focus on.
And what about you? What are the qualities that you're looking for in the candidate?
Well, for me, the right candidate will be, I'll ask myself a question, that has he impressed me with his speeches, with his tweets on Twitter, or how better he connects with the youth and everyone in my locality, for example. So for me, educational background will not be much of a problem, because I think the right knowledge and knowing his responsibilities are the main aspects, and he should focus on that. And as she said, that if he can deliver what he preaches, nothing like it.
So what, according to you, are the most reliable means to find out the qualifications and the background of a candidate?
See, the better source is yourself. You can go to the streets, you can look at the roads, you can look at the developments done by the local candidate. So the best, I would say, is you yourself. If you talk about sites, you have the election commission. The election commission website, you have the list of all the candidates who are contesting. So that is another big source from where you can get your information. Also, you have the Right to Information Act. So which you can send a RTI and you can get all the details necessary. So I would think these are the three reliable sources.
What about you? Do you want to add something to that?
Well, I think there's a social media app that is called MyNeta, in which you can get the idea or get the information about the politician, his past records, his criminal records, or how many, what are his assets, and everything. So I think that is one of the most reliable sources available right now.
So just before the elections, you have political parties going on an overdrive to promote their mandate. And they do this most often through social networking sites. So what's your take on that?
Social media, one such thing where people actually feel that we is something through which we could advertise, we could tell the public at large that this is what our agenda is, what we actually want to bring a change for. So social media is one such platform because of which people will come to know that, okay, fine, when this person talks, he's got the ability to actually get the change. And that's when we'll see to it that that fundamental change is brought and it'll benefit us at a whole.
And what about you? What is your take on this?
Social media can be considered as the cheapest mode of advertising. A person with a who has just started to work socially and he wants to participate in the elections, this is the best mode for him. And obviously for the politicians who are settled in, they can target the youth very well. So yes, I would say it plays a very important role, but I would also add to this, right, the politician or whosoever contestant is, whatever he's claiming to do for the public, he should stick to it. And it should be a genuine reason.
So as a student, what can you do to promote more awareness among people about the upcoming elections?
Basically, my ideology is people do things for two reasons. One is to gain pleasure out of it, and second is to avoid pain. So through the medium of social media, through dharnas, through marches, through signature campaigns, and whatever other conventional and non-conventional means that are available to me, I would like to convey to people this message that you're going to get this person for 60 months, he or she is going to be there with you for 60 months. So if you're going to choose a non-performer, you're stuck with him or her for 60 months.
How important are citizen forums according to you?
Citizens forums are very important for me because a person from a locality gets an opportunity to impress or cast his opinion in public. Whatever concerns he has with the locality, like the roads are not functional or whatsoever, they can voice their opinion in the forum, and we can make sure that whatever the complaint was is worked upon and the progress is in the way.
Citizen forums are often a big help to voters who are looking to gather that extra bit of information about candidates filing their nominations. Even though they start gathering information much before the elections kick off, the responsibilities shouldered by these forums don't just end with the elections. From compiling the achievements of a candidate to tracking the fulfillment of promises, forums like Agni in Mumbai and Bangalore's Political Action Committee, for instance, gave a thorough report card of candidates. Citizen forums played a big role in the 2014 general elections. Due to its highly interactive nature and extensive discussions, youngsters were motivated to cast their vote without fail. This tradition did not just end with the Lok Sabha polls. Abhishek, who is an MBA student, for instance, is an active member of a citizens forum in Navi Mumbai.
As we all know, there is a positive change at the national level, but still there was a debate amongst us that why not that same change at the local level, because we as a citizen face problem at local level, isn't it? So we need that positive change at our level. So one day while surfing Facebook, I got through one of my friend's page, and he has voted for citizens forums of Navi Mumbai. As from last 20 years, I'm part of Navi Mumbai. I wanted some positive change for this place. So I went into that place, into that website, Citizens Forum, and voted my perception about it, that what kind of candidate do we require for Navi Mumbai.
Abhishek isn't the only one taking out time to be a part of an initiative that creates awareness. A group of professionals in Navi Mumbai got together to start a citizen forum that lists out the qualities that the people in the area are looking for in their ideal candidate. After conducting an extensive survey using social media, the group is now presenting their findings to political leaders across the city.
Did you get the response you were looking for, the sort of response that you were hoping to achieve?
So in our website, we got close to 14,000 registrations. And if we see the 14,000 registration in comparison to in one assembly seat, the total number of votes that had happened last election, which was close to around 1.25 lakhs to 1.5 lakhs, it is a good 10% population, 10% vote population coming and visiting the website and registering themselves. If we look into that criteria, we had a good response.
Okay. And so you also use social media for this. Okay. You didn't go door to door. You used texting and mailing.
Absolutely.
And yeah. So how did that work? Do you think because of that you probably alienated a few other members?
Not really. I think our target group uses a lot of social media, and especially in Navi Mumbai, the penetration of internet is pretty good. I would feel that it is one of the highest in India. And then as professionals, we don't have that kind of time to really go out and reach out to people in the old traditional ways. I think it has worked well.
Okay. So since I'm assuming you all use the social media, you would have had a lot of response from students coming in.
Correct.
For this.
So we would have around 15,000 response, 15,000 registrations. I'm sure around 60-70% of them are students.
So after this, you're going to make the whole presentation in front of, you know, the elected members and the representatives, basically. So how do you see that going?
See, the way we look at it is that there is a group that we have formed, and we have votes of the people in terms of SMSs, and we will go and take it to them. And in fact, we have talked to some of them already, and it is just our hope. We have done our activity, and we hope that they will listen to us, and they will see the demographics and the people's response, and they will take it seriously. And take it forward from there. We hope that they will take it forward from there. We are just ensuring that we are strengthening a democracy by conducting an informal primary kind of a thing in this way that will help the overall process of election.
This is just a start. What we would intend to do is we would want to create a strong pressure group of professionals whereby we would contribute in pointing out shortcomings, giving suggestions for improvement, and we would be very keen in the city itself. We are not thinking for across the nation or something. We want to start really local, and we believe that we will be able to make a difference in the next 2 years.
What started as a small group now has 300 active members. This initiative by the Navi Mumbai Citizens Forum has been endorsed by many. Residents have come forward and listed out the basic qualifications they wish to see in their representatives.
When I got to know about Citizens Forum, that is through the posters, I went online and I saw the site, and I also got in touch with a few of the members, and whatever they had mentioned about the idea behind CFNM, it appealed to me a lot, because they had given us a choice whether you want a highly educated, not so highly, and low. Obviously, my choice will be highly educated.
While the Navi Mumbai Citizens Forum is doing their bit to spread awareness and to put into perspective just what are the qualities they're looking for a candidate who's representing them from their area, what now remains to be seen is just how many people follow suit and whether or not we will see more such initiatives from across the city. With video journalist Santosh Jagtap from Mumbai, Ankita Sinha for NDTV.